So one of the most interesting things about the voice that specifically this singer tends to think is that pitches go up in our voice. And our larynx doesn't know anything about a high note or a low note. All it knows is about faster vibrations. So when you want to get a high note, it's really about how fast your vocal folds are moving. I love helping people find their own voices, whatever it sounds like or however they need help getting words out, because not only do speech pathologists help with the sound of the voice, but it's the thought process of words, and it's so fascinating. When I was a high schooler, I had the opportunity to come to EVMS as a patient. I was singing for Virginia Opera, and they really wanted to help me with my voice, so they sent me to EVMS, and little did I know I was gonna meet a voice therapist and a laryngologist. And at that age, I was already singing for about 5 years, very seriously. I had no idea what my voice looked like. And they did a scope on me, and I just saw my voice box, the vocal folds, start moving when I was making sounds, and I thought it was so fascinating. The day after my scope, I sat down and I tried to figure out how I could be an otolaryngologist, because I thought it was so cool how they could help singers.
I would like you to start your warm-up with body first, yep. Then breath. So doing the straw exercises is really good.
Okay. When you work with someone for their voice, unlike any instrument, you can tell someone on the piano how to move their hands, or on a violin, how to adjust their wrist. But when it comes to your voice instrument, it's part of your body. So it can be very psychological if you say, that didn't sound good, or what's wrong with you? And I'm privileged that EVMS and I get to collaborate to work to build this program.
So I know your temptation will be to just start singing. You would have to work twice as long, three times as long, to loosen your body up vocally.
Right.
How it feels to treat people's voices is an incredible privilege. I honor that someone is coming very vulnerable, because when you close your eyes, you still can hear your voice. But imagine if your voice now sounds different. It can be devastating. There's also an emotional component. So to be a positive influence in a time of need, to help someone get back to their self and to do what they love in a safe way, is an honor.